All right. Let's get started. Actually, what are some of the extras I've unlocked? Concept art stuff. Yeah. Character gallery, soundtrack gallery. Up where we ended last time. This door is locked. Nearby power conduit must be energized to open it. Cordite. Space pirates now. I like the space pirates theme in this game. Turrets with your wave beam, they go haywire and start firing everywhere. Hydra granted. or pirate data. Our initial tests exposing Talon 4's indigenous parasites to Phazon appear to be successful. Increases in strength, size, and aggressiveness are common in all test subjects, as well as unforeseen evolutions, like additional poison sacs within the abdomen and the appearance of a second ring of mandibles in several subjects. These creatures were chosen because of their resilience, and it appears possible that given enough exposure to Phazon, they may one day be able to survive on any planet we transport them to. Our methods will have to be refined. We currently have a 100% extinction rate after the fourth infusion period, and most survivors of the third infusion stage are so violent and uncontrollable that they have to be euthanized. Even still, we remain hopeful that further experimentation will result in success. The lore I can. Is this a thing? Okay, nothing in there. It's just an empty tank. So much pirate lore here. I don't know if I'm gonna read it all. Most terraforming and retrofitting of security checkpoints on Talon 4 is complete, but we continue to research the alarming epidemic of the breaches by local creatures. Door records show no unauthorized entries, so we must presume the creatures are either slipping in undetected during daily personnel moves, or else finding their way in through subterranean tunnels. We have found many small breaches of this latter sort and plugged them wherever we can, but it is unlikely that we will ever achieve full extermination within our current timetable. Mining operations have begun near the crater where Phazon appears to be most concentrated. Daily Phazon yields have increased 44%, and our mining system becomes more streamlined as personnel and equipment flows increase. Several incidents of Phazon-induced madness have been reported, prompting augmented life support regulations in the deeper chambers. Symptoms include loss of equilibrium, erratic respiration, muscle spasms, and in the most extreme cases, hallucinations. A timeline reassessment for the refinery operation is recommended, as the material proves more unstable than initial analysis indicated. We have codified the newfound energy source as Phazon, a V-index mutagen, of which we have very little reliable data. Indications point to a meteor of unknown origin expelling Phazon into the environment. This material appears to possess the power to mutate organic life forms sufficiently to withstand its poison. These mutations appear promising, with abrupt evolutionary leaps appearing in single-generation reproduction. Plans to establish a full science team on Talon 4 are being finalized. Desol. Turn on the elevator. A Metroid. Research outpost Glacier 1 in the Vendrana Drift region of Talon 4's mountains is operating at 85% capacity. Sub-zero temperatures have made the Metroid sluggish and easy to control, even those well into Phazon infusion cycles. Cold containment stasis tanks are sufficient for the juveniles, but some of the larger Metroids have been moved to quarantine caves for safety purposes. Security doors remain an issue, as malfunctions due to ice occur every day. Large predators in the wastes are also a concern, as they continue to kill personnel and breach secure areas. Unfortunately, it has become clear that our containment teams cannot neutralize all of them without a vast increase in munitions and soldiers. not handle sedated xenomes without proper ice container equipment. Good advice. Phase on mining is underway. Several garrisons have been established, and terraforming of the Chozo ruins is underway. Security systems are operational, and science team continues to make progress in their biotech research. The Finjana Drifts have proven to be an optimal location for research headquarters, and soon it will be joined by a fully operational combat base in Starport. If Command's predictions are half true, we shall rise to dominance in the sector within the Adeka cycle. Truly, these are glorious times. Pirate data everywhere. Scans of the spiral sector detected a massive energy spike emanating from a Wanderer-class planet identified as Talon 4. Scout reconnaissance was immediately dispatched to the center of the spike, a landmass at heading mark 40.8.2, returning with planetary samples and atmospheric imaging. Analysis shows the energy source to be an unstable radioactive material of enormous potential. We are unable to form an accurate risk assessment at this time, but we are unlikely to find an energy source this powerful again. Analysis will continue, but currently Talon 4 appears to be a viable secondary headquarters. Scan the bomb slots, right? Yes. Thing. Let's do some scans. Planet Ormine 2. 2.3 trillion teratons. An uninhabitable wasteland savaged by nuclear dust storms and constant seismic upheavals. planet Zebes, 4.8 trillion teratons. Planet's crust is primarily earthic ore, making it ideal for subterranean construction. A class 19 planet, Zebes is inhospitable to most bioforms. The world was considered unremarkable until it became a base for space pirate forces. Twin Tabula. Planet is best known for Twin Fever, a disease caused by a viral strain native to Twin Tabula. In the early stages of the disease, victims suffer from double vision. When the twin sight fades, the victim is near death. Talon 4. Ecosystem studies indicate that Talon 4 was a biological paradise prior to the impact of an extraterrestrial object. What remains of the biosphere is slowly fading due to exposure to phason radiation. At current rate of decay, Talon 4 will be a barren class 13 wasteland in approximately 25 years. Got my Roman numerals all mixed up for a second there. Planet Bilium. Quarantine atmosphere is rife with Mitteralis, a sentient gaseous global exterminator virus. That sounds cool. Did I scan all the planets? That's just the... yeah. Okay. Time to go up then. First, so we can save. Oh, so glad it's finally the weekend. And what do we have here? Super missiles. Charge the power beam, then fire a missile. New extras, cool. Ooh, I've scared you guys, yes. Super missiles on these guys. Yeah. Ow. Wish changing beam weapons didn't feel so clunky. Hold one button, then press another one. Not great. But oh well. Metroids. This game takes place before Metroid 2, so Samus hasn't committed genocide on him yet. The reconstruction of Geoform 187, codenamed Ridley, was recently completed. After his defeat on Zebes, Command ordered a number of metagenetic improvements for him. Though aggressive, we were able to implement these changes in a cycle. The metamorphosis was painful, but quite successful in the end. Early tests indicate a drastic increase in strength, mobility, and offensive capability. Cybernetic modules and armor plating have been added as well. We believe our creation, now called Meta Ridley, will become the mainstay of our security force, a job he will certainly relish. Any other pirate lore in here? New? Alright. Talon Metroid, energy-based parasitic predator. The effects of Phazon have turned these Metroids, a species of alpha predators native to SR388, into a unique subspecies found only on Talon 4. A Talon Metroid will latch onto its prey and drain energy, growing larger as it does. The only way to shake an attached Talon Metroid is to enter morph ball mode and lay a bomb. Ice cream yet, so I can't freeze them. There. More missiles and more health. You can always shoot a missile at these stasis tanks. Or these tubes or whatever, and free the Metroid if you want to fight it. Don't really get anything for it though. Metroid dissection continues to prove more questions than answers. Our research teams have isolated the energy conduits that run from the invasive twin mandibles to the energy core in the creature's quadripartite nucleus. But the manner in which a Metroid actually extracts the life force from its prey remains an utter mystery. The victim does not lose blood or any other vital fluids, and yet the Metroid extracts energy. Identifying this energy is our central problem. It takes no physical form, and yet without it, the victim dies. We will continue to research this matter, as the isolation of this life-giving essence could be the key to our ascendance. Recording to logbook. Studies of Metroid biology continue, though with limited progress. It seems like seems likely that we will be much more successful using the Metroids for our means rather than trying to reproduce their powers. If they could be adequately tamed, we would have no need of a proper understanding of their metabolism. A small force of disciplined Metroids could wipe out entire armies, and once we find a way to shield them from cold containment weapons, they will be invincible. Furthermore, if we could then harvest the energy they'd consumed, we would have a near limitless source of power at our disposal. Yeah, I don't say Metroids are invincible. I just took one down and I didn't have an ice beam. Ice tools. Central tank control circuit connection terminated. Testing of thermal imaging software complete. Commence download to tactical visor prototype for field testing. This unit supplies power to the containment force field at the bottom of the room. So it wasn't a new type of turret. Yep, it's a common old auto turret. Yada yada. Central tank auxiliary circuit connection terminated. Way different than this one. Kind of blurry. Man, the missile's not tracking. And my wave beam were both just shooting straight, even though I was locked onto the guy. I don't remember that happening before. Who knows? Things got these conduits that I need to can only see with a thermal visor. I have to shoot them with the wave beam to power whatever. Let's scan this guy. Sentry drone. Super missile. Static buildup. There's a fun thing you can do, I forgot about. You can free Metroids and have them attack the pirates for you. See him. Whew. Having a swell day today. Oh my gosh, that's all you guys get. I need to save. Those guys were a pain in the butt. Should have super listened to me. Don't come over here, Mr. Metroid. Attack them space pirates first, please. Can be destroyed with super missiles. This little tube thing. Bam. Metroids get bigger in this game as they absorb energy from you or pirates or whoever. Maybe I'm remembering that wrong, or I imagined it or something. Now there's another one. The pirate's not really even attacking the Metroid. Just kind of runs around. Ooh. Damn quick. Scan, yeah. One missile? Nice. Save again, and I'm back to where I started the stream. Actually, was this cordite cover on this thing always here? Metroid, I love me some Metroid too. Oops. How's your day been going, Valorfall? Yeah. Oh, damn it. Oh, well. Should have just boosted through. Been busy. Yeah. That didn't sound fun. Sentient creature of stone charged with phazon radiation. The phazon radiation given off by Thardis negates auto-targeting systems, preventing lock-on. It may be possible to acquire alternate targets with a different visor. The chaotic nature of phazon radiation leads to instability in its structural integrity. Thardis can encase targets in ice, and its colossal size and strength make it a formidable opponent. Cool. Missiles, shoot. There we go. Give him rocks. Just health. I need missiles. Missiles. There's missiles. Ooh. So a little ball again. Oh. Fail out of wood. Man, I still can't control. Wish I could control the camera so I could see where he was. To the remaster. It's a camera control when you're in morph ball mode. Ashley, welcome. Thanks for stopping by. I appreciate it. How has your day been going? This is like way cooler. Good. Yeah, my little good. Pretty average day at work. And now I'm home playing more of my favorite game ever. Every Metroid game is one of my favorite games ever. Time. Again. I love this scene. Bonk. New upgrade. Cooler looking morph ball. ZL to use the spider ball. Uh, This now. I can travel along these rails. Can I boost? No. That wasn't a thing until the sequel. First. Oh, I can't open white doors yet. Going back to the lava place. Machine is functional, but is not yet receiving power. Three nearby power conduits must be energized. Okay. Here's one. God, not you guys. Access to each channel granted. On a timer. Channel granted. There we go. Maximum health increased. Yes. Bendizium. Don't have anything that can destroy Bendizium. Guess we go this way. Got a puddle spore. Mouth thing, let me flip over. I scanned you guys right, yes, burrowers. To get the grapple beam sometime soon. Oh, got away with my missile. You go to hell and you die. To go from here. Cannot. Let's get this guy right, yes. Yeah. Chose the ruins. ribs, my old friends. Oh, you still hurt. Forgot how much it used to hurt. I can go up here now. Got more Tony Hawk stuff. Was it this way or the other way? Other way. In this room, but still shaking. Plated puffer. Penny says hi. Hi, Penny. I plan to come visit you soon. I've been saying that forever, but maybe I actually mean it this time. Wave Buster. Combine missiles with my wave beam. Down here. I cannot reach that yet. Damn water slowing me down. Okay, this way was not progress. So where is the progress? This way. Shot your butt. I got what's up there, right? Yeah. Straight throwing wasp hives. Bam. Fountain to go off again, yay! This is not progress, just another missile expansion. But those are always nice to have. Here now. More missiles. Plated parasites. Lots of them. Beetles are everywhere. Chozodor. What is this otherworldly pestilence that infests the land, seeking out life in its blind need for corruption? And where did the meteor that brought it originate? Was it crafted by alien hands, or is it a roving chunk of a planet that suffered a violent end? Our minds quail in horror at the thought that long ago, in some corner of the universe as yet unseen by our eyes, an entire planet was perhaps once coated with this great poison. Whatever cataclysm may have ruptured the doomed place must have been mighty indeed. And if other meteors from it spread through space, bearing this evil to the far corners of the universe, we hold fast to the hope that this is not so, that the only surviving remnants of this evil are here on Talon 4. Then at least there is hope for its eradication. Spoilers, it's not. There are two other Metroid Prime games. technically like four. Tony Hawk time. Whee. More lore. To the entrusted one, if you read these words, then our hope has not been in vain. Your path is fraught with danger. Monstrosities beyond description lurk in the shadows, starving, hunting for prey, searching for ways to quench the poisonous urges that bloom in their brains. Some of these are shrewd, but they are blinded by their evil designs. Believing in the black promise of the great poison, they seek to harness it for their own ends. It is these last that are the greatest danger. When you rid the universe of these creatures, you will be the true and trusted one. None know if our temple, the cradle, will prove powerful enough to contain this evil forever. For now, it wraps around that abomination, cutting it off from the world above. However, we believe the power of Cypher, which has been produced by linking the 12 artifacts, should be strong enough. The fate of this world is now left to the one who will collect all the artifacts in the future. The time when the entrusted one knows is approaching. Many Chozo are gifted with a distant sight, and even more begin to learn it as our harmonization with the universe becomes more and more complete. We peer forward, seeing prophecy in the ripples of the water, hearing rumors of coming days on the breath of the wind. Though we celebrate the distant sight, many of these visions are dark. The worst of the prophecies, and the most common, tells of the coming of the worm. Born from parasites nurtured in a poisoned womb, the worm grows, devouring from within until the world begins to rot. Not all prophecies come to pass, of course, but we cannot help but fear this dark portent. Are you Cordite? You're Cordite. So I can destroy you with a super missile. Something behind the wall seems to have been activated. Actually, can I scan the spider ball rails now? I think they're research data. Not these ones, I guess. Pretty sure they're scannable, though. Time to start counting. I was in there so fast. Anything this way? Nope. Just the missiles. Okay, not that different. Chozo ghosts, spectral entity, bioelectric field, and vulnerable to natural energies. So these guys will be a pain for a while. Can only be hurt with the power beam. Maybe missiles. Oops. And do that. Don't seem to hurt him either. actually something. Yeah, Chozo lore. Things bound to earthly shapes are temporal and frail, existing in a single dimension. They are fragile, vulnerable, and ultimately mortal. However, not all things obey this law. Shapeless, they wait beyond the realm of perception, emerging only when one arrives who can feel their presence. Such is the will of the Chozo. Our will to defeat the evil seeping into this planet remains. We desire only to see the darkness meet its end. The will of the Chozo has no mind or reasoning of its own, though. This will be the entrusted one's trial. Alright. Up in a ball. Charger. Yes. Not too many of these in the game, but I am low on missiles. Controller's starting to peel off. Oh well. Might be time to just remove it. I've had it for a few years. Drainage shut off is holding, maintaining the water level of the reflecting pool at 95%. First floor. More of these stone toads. More Tony Hawk. Which button is the bombs? Ah, I'm gonna press the button that turned me back to normal. Too. Got a save point. Let's see what's through here. I don't think it's anything I need to do yet. So another elevator, where does it go? Talon Overworld. I will not go there yet. To anything but bombs in the mouth. Another elevator. So also goes to the Talon Overworld. Shot. Museum. I can't go this way yet. Is I just not supposed to come this way at all yet? That might be the case. I'm gonna go back and try that other elevator again. This one leads. I think I need to go back to Thendrana again. burning. No, I gotta freeze. It's gonna shatter. I'm not gonna go in there yet. Oh, that's not where I need to go. I'm just gonna have to turn around to fight you. Killed you. Certain suit that lets me move in water. This crate appears to be the same type of container found on the space pirate research frigate. The material seeping out from the ruptured metal is highly toxic. Analysis indicates that this may be the phazon compound the space pirates were using in their biological experiments. First look at real phazon. Ice is over when you charge the ice beam, and I love it. I had to take that out of the Wii version. But it was such a cool effect. I'm glad they brought it back. Back to my ship. I shall save. Shots him. Nice. Sound. Stuck. Yeah, okay. This way. can freeze these things too. I can. Stupid flamethrowers. Ain't getting in my way again. Freeze, freeze. Beam. What are you doing chilling up there? There we go. Bam. I scanned everything up. That was important in here, I guess. Dead babies. Search lab over this way. I can destroy you now. Secret. Missiles. The right way. I'm dumb. Jump this. Oh, there's a shortcut. I have to go all the way through that other room again. what is it? Me a little. Trying to knock me down so you can attack me? Too bad. You're scared. Normal scarabs. You're not ice scarabs or nothing. Fires really slowly. Yeah, it's research rail. And it makes a nice shortcut back up here. Go back to the save point. Or something for dinner. I don't feel like going anywhere. There's nothing around here to eat. Pizza, pizza. Send a Metroid to finish the rest of them off. I do like sausage and pineapple. I don't like pepperoni and sausage, really. I'll probably like sausage, pineapple, and onion. Those are my toppings of choice. Battlefall's still here. You kill all the pirates, little baby. Little Metroid. Do I need to finish you off now? You're still flying around up there. Pepperoni, sausage, and onion. One for me now. No more space pirates. Turret. Say Watson, pineapple on pizza, yes or no? What side do you fall on this? Excuse me. God, that was still through the store. Okay, phew. Yet. I know. Go back up a ways, go through the other door. Like an ice scarab or something. New creature, Hunter Metroid. Energy siphon tentacle increases its threat level. As Metroids develop, they become more efficient predators. Still weak to ice. And what are you? Glider. I can't do anything to you guys yet. You're not hostile anyway, so. Spot now. There it is. Still locked onto it, but Doesn't look any different from the rest of the spike. Pretty sure there's a save room through this door. Any pirate lore I need to scan? Nope. Missile expansion under the water there, but I can't get to it yet. Story of my life. Also, listen to that music. This is like the best track in the game. Kind of repetitive right now, but it gets good. Oh, there it goes. Anything in the water. God, I'm stuck. Were these here in the original? I don't recall them. Suit. suit acquired. Movement in liquid environments is no longer hindered. Look how much better I can see now. Elevator. Let's reach the elevator. I'm going to take a short break, use the restroom, and order some food. Should be back in a few minutes. Thank you. Okay. Take a short break here. We'll be back. Okay. Yeah. Food's ordered. Bladder is drained. Where the hell am I going? the save room back there. Maybe I should use that. Right, that way it was blocked. So I need to go back this way. And that elevator to the Talon Overworld should work. Thank you, M. Ashley. Thanks for sticking around. I just found out you could actually freeze those flamethrowers with the ice beam. 21 years of playing this game and I never knew that. Discovering new things all the time. Keep streaming until my food gets here. What does the tracker say? It doesn't have a window on one. It's going in the oven right now, though. Back down here. phase on thing go. Here when I came through here the first time. So, we are actually back in the spaceship I was on at the very beginning of the game. This is where it crash landed. These guys, little crab guys, Talon Crab, 75%. Pirates just in the water. Station's still here. Do I need to power this door too? Yes, I do. Sesame. Missile tank. Or energy tank, I mean. Hiding in the elevator. Okay. How many are there? Just three. Awkward drone. Double kill. And I blew open this door. Three bird with one stone. Another power door. Feeling a little excessive. Where's number 30? There it is. Dead pirate. Aqua sex. Oh, so close. Hang on. Phone call. Never mind, it was just the pre-recorded Domino's message that I guess my pizza's. Yep. Pizza's done being made at least. Ah. Do I have to get the timing right on these water jumps? Parts of it. Ow. Rude. Lamp things. Hard to hit. Where does this lead? Intense radiation detected. Look at all the phase on. To Phazon Mines granted. New area. Estimated time to arrival about 7 minutes. Of course, I find that to be highly inaccurate with Domino's. Might take longer, which I'm okay with. More time to play. Phazon Mines. Yeah, I'll probably have to peel off this decal on my controller. These are new turrets. These are new ones at some point. Mega turret. Seem right. Yeah, they're close enough. Wow, I'll just change to 2 minutes. I might actually be here soon after all. Now, it definitely was not 5 minutes, but I think this is a good place to stop anyways. Guess next time I play, I'll be exploring the Phazon Mine some more. Alright, thank you all for watching the stream. I do appreciate it very much. And this should be uploaded on YouTube in the next day or two. Don't know when I'll stream next. Just kind of whenever I have the opportunity. But I will see you all later. Bye, I'm Ashley.